For over 25 years, students from across the Granite State have come together to match wits with their peers. The competition can be fierce, but so can the fun.
Even so, the stakes are high because only one team can win. The Granite State Challenge! Now, here's your host, Jim Janot.
Hi again, everybody, and welcome once again to Granite State Challenge, week number 3 of our 4 quarterfinal round games. 2 schools have won games to move into our upcoming semifinal round. The winner tonight will also be advancing into that semifinal round of competition. So let's introduce you to the 2 schools playing in tonight's quarterfinal round game. School number 1 is Coe-Brown Northwood Academy, with an enrollment of about 650 students, located in New Hampshire's Rockingham County.
Hi, my name is Michelle Fiocaprelli, and I'm a senior.
Hi, my name is Nicholas Sylvester, and I'm a junior.
Hi, my name is Anthony Craven, and I'm a junior.
Hi, my name is Justin Loy, and I'm a senior.
The team is coached by Lorraine Drake. Her alternates tonight are Jacana Surasak and Mark Davis, the Black Bears of Coe-Brown Northwood Academy. All right, that is the team from Coe-Brown. Let us introduce you now to their opponents. And they come to us from Manchester Central High School, enrolling some 2,300 students, and it's located in New Hampshire's Hillsborough County.
Hi, I'm Ben Sturgio, and I'm a senior.
I'm Nico Gallo, and I'm a senior.
I'm David Nider, and I'm also a senior.
I'm Angel Vloy, and I'm a senior.
With us, the coaches for the team, Sean Russell and Mike Hennessy. Their alternates are Nick Ambrogi and Olivia Papp, and they are the Little Green of Manchester Central High School. All right, those are the 2 teams. One last introduction. That's to let you know who our judges are, and they are Mary Riley Potter and Ann Belanger. All right, we're ready to go in round number 1, which is our 10-point toss-up round, and then the bonus and 60-second rounds come up a little bit later on. Right now, Coe-Brown and Manchester Central, these are 10-point toss-ups. Good luck. The early Greeks believed that their gods lived on top of the highest mountain in their country. David of Manchester Central.
Mount Olympus.
Mount Olympus is the name. Correct for 10 points. Now we want you to answer this question about Clement C. Moore's poem, A Visit from St. Nicholas. What did the bundle of toys on his back make him look like? David of Central.
Santa Claus.
Coe-Brown. The bundle of toys made him look like a peddler just opening his pack. Here we go for 10 points. Identify the element with an electronegativity value of 0.9. Its symbol is, David of Manchester Central.
Francium.
I can repeat it for Coe-Brown. Identify the element with an electronegativity value of 0.9. Its symbol is Na. Anthony.
Nicium.
It is sodium. Here we go for 10 points. First of all, we want you to listen carefully. You might want to write something down on the paper if you feel you need to, but use estimation and mental computation to determine which of the following has a product of 1,426. 53 times 12, 62 times 23, 52 times 29. Ben of Manchester Central.
62 times 23.
62 times 23 is correct for the 10 points. All right, here we go for 10. Identify the OAS, an organization that condemned the actions of the United States in Panama back in 1989. The OAS is the Organization of American States. For 10 points, teams, which traditional song includes the lines, should old acquaintance be forgot and never David of Manchester Central?
Auld Sing Lang.
Coe-Brown. Michelle.
Grand Old Flag.
Actually, David, you were there, but you kind of got your consonants mixed up a little bit. It's Auld Lang Syne. Here we go for 10 points. Which name identifies both the device used to draw a circle And the device that determines Nico of Manchester Central?
A compass.
Determines the direction of the north magnetic pole. The compass is right. Which word from the Greek for sweet wine identifies the most common kind of sugar in plant and animal tissues? Its formula is C6H12O6, David of Central.
Glucose.
Glucose is right. Beaches along which coast of the United States tend to be narrow and backed by steep cliffs? Nico of Manchester Central.
East.
Coe-Brown. Justin.
West.
Why not? We'll take west or the Pacific coast. Paper and pencil in front of you. What integer is 2/17 of 51? What integer is 2/17 of 51, Anthony of Coe-Brown?
Six.
Six is correct. The following are all breeds of what type of animal? Pomeranian, Maltese, Ben of Manchester Central.
Dog.
They are dogs, correct. Which term used in psychology means excessive or neurotic admiration of oneself and is derived, Ben of Manchester Central?
Obsession.
I can repeat it for Coe-Brown. Which, Michelle?
Narcissism.
Narcissism is correct. In 1995, for the first time, astronomers confirmed the discovery of a large planet that is circling a star similar to our sun. In which constellation, named for a winged horse in Greek mythology, is this star located? Ben of Central?
Pegasus.
Pegasus is right. Now what we'd like you to do is name the women warriors who aided the Trojans during the Trojan War. Ben of Central?
The Amazons.
Amazons, correct. Name the kind of musical composition for voices and orchestra that resembles a modern cantata but is shorter and not confined to a religious theme. David of Manchester Central.
Aria.
Coe-Brown. Anthony.
Fugue.
It is an oratorio. An oratorio. Which word beginning with the prefix omni means all-knowing? Nico of Manchester Central.
Omniscient.
That is correct for 10 points. Still in round number one, we go with another 10-point toss-up. Which Spanish phrase, meaning the little girl, names the cold water event that occurs, Nico of Manchester Central?
El Niño.
If I can repeat for Coe-Brown, which, Nick?
La Nina.
La Nina is correct for the 10 points. How many degrees are in a straight angle, David of Manchester Central?
108.
Coe-Brown, Justin?
180.
180 degrees is correct. Against which country did the United States launch a ground war called the Mother of All Battles on February 23rd, 1991? It was against Iraq. Here we go for 10 points. A 14-year-old from Tennessee correctly spelled kamikaze to win the 66th National Spelling Bee. Spell kamikaze. Ben of Central.
K-A-M-I-K-A-Z-E.
You got it. Kamikaze is correct. Of the vitamins B, D, and K, a deficiency of which one causes rickets? David of Central.
K.
Coe-Brown. Michelle.
B.
That leaves us with D. All right, let's go for 10 points. What was the most famous acquisition of Jefferson's first administration? Nick of Coe-Brown.
The Louisiana Purchase.
The Louisiana Purchase is right. An Oscar-winning documentary focuses on the career of Maya Lin, the architect whose design was chosen over 1,440 other entries for which Washington, D.C. memorial, Andrew of Central?
The Vietnam Memorial.
The Vietnam Veterans Memorial is correct. And there's the sound ending our round. Well, we've had a good high scoring round. Manchester Central grabbing the early lead by a score of 100-60. We'll go into our bonus round in just a moment. Before we get there, though, Laurie Warren joins us, as she has throughout the season. Today, she's talking with the captains of the two teams. Right now, she's talking with the captain from Coe-Brown, Northwood Academy.
Thank you, Jim. We're in the studio with the captain of the Coe-Brown Academy team, Michelle Fiacaprelli. Now, Michelle, how did you get to be the captain?
It was a little bit by chance. It was a little bit more outspoken. So when I said, I want to be captain, no one really said anything against it. So it kind of just happened.
Was there a fear factor there?
Yeah, maybe a little bit.
Okay. Now, as you were preparing to come to Granite State Challenge, what sort of things did you do to get ready for the show?
We meet about once a week, and we play kind of games like Trivial Pursuit. We go online and look up educational quizzes, so it's not just complete random information, but We do go home and study a little bit too. Like, we get lists of authors and books and just important things we learned in school.
And does the coach have some good tips for you too? Or?
Yeah, she's been doing this for a lot longer than any of us has been here. So she has some prior experience and she's really been helpful through this whole thing.
Yeah, and they, you know, the teachers do put a lot of effort into it.
Yeah, she's great. We love Mrs. Drake.
Yeah, she is cool. And then is there any favorite memory that you might have of all of the things that have happened so far?
We do the regular quiz bowl things at different schools. So we go around, we have like mini competitions. Mm-hmm. At one time, we actually got pretty far. We got to like one of the finals, and then we lost, but it was still good to get to go somewhere new.
Yeah, where was that at?
I think Manchester? Oh, okay. Maybe it was Manchester. I'm not sure.
They have what, three schools in Manchester? High schools?
There's a lot.
Yeah, it's huge. So anyway, well, speaking of Manchester, that's who we're taking on today. So yeah. We'll get back to the game now, and the best of luck to you. Thanks so much for coming out with us. Okay, back to you in the studio, Jim.
All right, Lori, as you look at Michelle and her teammates right now after round number one, right in the middle of this thing, trailing by 100-60 scores, we come to our bonus round. We'll still ask the 10-point toss-up questions. If the team identifies the question correctly, they'll have a chance at additional bonus points. So Coe-Brown Academy, Manchester Central, here we go. Let's go back to the paper and pencil to start this round. If the area of a square is 36 square inches, then what is the perimeter of the square? David of Manchester Central.
Inches, 24 inches.
Yeah, that is correct for the 10 points. So over to Central we go. Ben, you're the captain. You'll speak for them as we go through this round. Right now, choose from a category of history potpourri, Paraguay, or minor league math. History potpourri, Paraguay, or minor league math.
History potpourri.
Let's go with the history potpourri. Identify for 5 points each of the following concerning U.S. history. Astronaut who on May 5th, 1961 became the first American in space.
Alan Shepard.
Correct. Keystone State, where the first major oil well was drilled near Titusville in 1859.
Colorado.
The Keystone State is Pennsylvania. And the adopted name of the person born Leslie Lynch King Jr., the U.S. president who was succeeded by Jimmy Carter. Try an answer.
Richard Nixon.
It was Gerald Ford. All right, we get 5 out of the 15 on the bonus. Here we go for 10 points. Which word for a 500th anniversary designates the celebration begun, Nico of Central?
Quincentennial.
Quincentennial is correct. So right back to you, Central. For Paraguay, minor league math or ancient art? Paraguay, minor league math or ancient art?
Minor league math.
Let's go with the minor league math. In the equation y equals 2x minus 1, solve for y if x has the following values. 1.
1.
Correct. Negative 2.
Negative 5.
Correct. 5.
9.
I told you that was minor league math, but major league points, 15 out of 15 on the bonus. Here we go for 10 points. Name the kind of medical practitioner who operates on the theory that disease is the result of impaired nerve functioning and therefore uses, Ben of Manchester Central.
Neurologist.
I can repeat it for Coe-Brown. Name the kind of medical practitioner who operates on the theory that disease is the result of impaired nerve functioning and therefore uses massages and manipulation of the vertebrae in treating patients. Nick.
Chiropractor.
Chiropractor will get you 10 points, and we'll come over to Coe-Brown, where Michelle is the team captain. Paraguay, ancient art, or south of the border? Paraguay, ancient art, or south of the border?
South of the border.
Let's go with south of the border. And again, Michelle, I take your answer as the team's answer. Identify each of the following concerning Mexico. Largest of its rivers emptying into the Gulf of California.
The Rio Grande.
It is the Colorado River. Its city on the Rio Grande, opposite El Paso, Texas. Its city on the Rio Grande, opposite El Paso, Texas, is Juarez. And its town on the U.S. border near San Diego, California.
Tijuana.
That is correct. 5 out of 15 on the bonus. Here we go for 10 points. James Monroe, upon his inauguration as president, became the fourth member of the so-called Virginia dynasty. Name two of the other three presidents who made up this group. Ben of a Central.
George Washington and Thomas Jefferson.
Along with James Madison, that is correct, via 10 points. So back over to the little green we go for Paraguay, ancient art or big spender. Paraguay, ancient art, big spender.
Ancient art.
Let's go with the ancient art for 5 points apiece. Identify each of the following concerning painting. Virgil's hero in the Aeneid, whose story is often depicted in art.
Aeneas.
Correct. Leader of the Greeks at Troy, who is sometimes shown in connection with the sacrifice of his daughter.
Agamemnon.
Thank you. Biblical garden frequently depicted showing Christ and three sleeping disciples.
Oh, no.
Gethsemane.
That is correct. 15 out of 15 on the bonus. All right, let's get one more in here. Teams for 10 points. The U.S. government gave growers permission in 2001 to market which fruit as dried plums, since the traditional name has come to suggest, David of Central?
Prune.
Prunes is right for the 10 points. Back at you, Central, for Paraguay, big spender or hail to the chief. Paraguay, big spender, hail to the chief.
Big spender.
Let's go with the big spender. 13 states or parts of states were carved from the Louisiana Purchase of 1803. Identify any three of them for 5 points apiece.
Louisiana, Nebraska,
Kansas. Louisiana, Nebraska, and Kansas.
Louisiana, Nebraska, and Kansas is in there, so we're going to give you 15 out of 15 on the bonus. All right, we're ready for another 10-point no and on. We'll do that a little bit later in the program. Well, Central took advantage of the bonus round to open up a lead here halfway through the game by a score of 190 to 75. 60-second round right around the corner. Before we get there, though, let's call a timeout. Ask Lori to come back in. This time she's talking with the captain from Manchester Central High School.
And thank you, Jim. We are here talking with the captain of Manchester Central, Ben Sturgio. Now, Ben, welcome to the hot seat, as it were.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Now, as the captain of the team, how did you get to be the captain? That's our
first
question.
As I was talking with my coach, and I said, Coach, why did you become the captain? And he said, well, you have the least controversial hair on the team, so you're going to be the leader of this one. And I said, all right, Coach, I'll do it.
Good hair wins out every time,
apparently.
I'm telling you. And the rest of your life, it will work, too. And as you were preparing to come to the show or for Quiz Bowl, what kind of things did you do to get ready?
Well, our coach had a book of questions from the quiz bowl, and he just read them out to us, and we'd have bells, and we'd ring and try and get the answer.
Oh, so yeah, you actually had to practice with the bells?
Well, we didn't have the buzzers. We just had like a little bell you hit in the game.
No, as long as there's something you had to do, like a physical kind of movement to get you ready to come. Well, that's a great idea.
Yeah.
And then our last question would be, is there any like fond memory, anything that happened or anything funny or anything you'd like to share with
us? Like all this is hilarious. Like, I love my teammates. Mm-hmm. I mean, we're all great friends. We work well together. And even just the trips up here, we ride up in two different cars. We have the Fun V and the other car, and I'm in the Fun V. So the Fun V is great. And yeah, just a blast overall. I'm just really happy to be here.
No, we're so glad to have you here too. So we'll have to get back into the studio now, find out what's going to happen today. We are turning it back over to Jim at Granite State Challenge.
All right, thank you to Ben and to Lori for joining us between the rounds. Now we get into our third round, which is our 60-second round. We'll ask each team 10 questions in 1 minute. Reward them with 10 points for every correct answer. Bonus them 10 if they get them all right in under a minute. So the team that trails does choose the category first. So we go over to Coe-Brown, and you can choose from U.S. presidents, life science, or rivers. U.S. presidents, life science, or rivers?
Life science.
Let's go with the life science. And Michelle, you talked to everybody, but I take your answer for the team. Identify each of the following concerning life science from the given letter. Start the clock. D, initialism used for deoxyribonucleic acid.
DNA. DNA.
Correct. B, reproductive process in which a cell divides into two cells, the one used by most bacteria.
Pass.
C, thread-like body found in the nucleus of a cell.
Pass.
A, microscopic unicellular organism that lives in fresh and salt water.
Plankton?
Amoeba. E, very young plant or animal before hatching or birth.
Embryo?
Correct. F, long hair-like, whip-like structure that propels in
flagella.
Correct. H, process of crossbreeding plants or animals of different varieties or species.
Hybrid.
Think of that, judges. M, a process that results in cells with one half the normal number of chromosomes.
Meiosis.
Correct. N, thin membrane separating the nucleus. And there we go, judges. They get 4 out of 10 on their 60-second round. So 40 points onto the scoreboard for Coe-Brown, and over to Manchester Central we go. For Rivers or for U.S. presidents?
I'll take Rivers.
Rivers.
Let's go with the Rivers. And Ben, I'll take your answer for the team. Identify each of the following associated with Rivers. Start the clock. River flowing from Colorado into New Mexico that is the subject of water disputes between the U.S. and its southern neighbor.
Colorado River.
It is the Rio Grande. River formed by the Monongahela and Allegheny at Pittsburgh.
Ohio.
Correct. Alaska's major river, means of transportation for Klondike gold miners.
Yukon.
Correct. Country known for its plain between the Tigris and Euphrates rivers.
Iraq.
Correct. River forming the boundary between Maryland, Virginia, and West Virginia.
Potomac.
Potomac.
Correct. River General Washington crossed it to defeat
Delaware.
The Hessians.
Delaware.
Correct. River forming the boundary between Washington and Oregon. That is the second longest in the Western Hemisphere to empty into the Pacific.
Snake.
Say again.
Snake.
It is Columbia. South African river with a colorful name.
Yellow.
It is orange. 418-mile long river in Italy that flows from the Alps to the Adriatic Sea.
The Rhine.
It is the Po. And Europe's longest river is Volga. Judges, they get 5 out of 10 on there. 60-second round. So things pretty much drawn pretty even in round number 3, but Central got that big lead during the bonus round, holding on to it as we head into our fourth and final round. 10-point toss-ups the rest of the way. No more talking to each other teams. Here we go. Identify the Shakespearean pair whose surnames are Montague and Capulet. Nick of Coe-Brown.
Romeo and Juliet.
Romeo and Juliet is right. Some Colorado physicist made 2,000 atoms slow to a crawl and merge into a strange new form of matter, creating a temperature only 4 billionths of a degree above absolute zero. Justin of Coe-Brown.
Boys, Einstein condensate.
I can repeat it for us. Central, some Colorado physicist made 2,000 atoms slow to a crawl and merge into a strange new form of matter, creating a temperature only 4 billionths of a degree above absolute zero. What is the Kelvin equivalent of absolute zero? Ben.
0 degrees Kelvin.
0 Kelvin is correct. Who said, I pledge you, I pledge myself to a new deal for the American people? Ben of Manchester Central.
FDR.
Franklin Roosevelt is right. Identify the English architect who redesigned Nico of Manchester Central.
Wren.
He must be a popular one. Sir Christopher Wren is right for your 10 points. Now for 10 points, name the New England author whose great-great-grandfather was a magistrate, Andrew of Manchester Central.
Nathaniel Hawthorne.
Say again?
Nathaniel Hawthorne,
that is correct for the 10 points. Normally, a molecule of oxygen contains 2 atoms, but how many oxygen atoms are in a molecule of the form of oxygen known as ozone? Nico of Manchester Central.
3
is right. One last math question for the day. Teams, paper and pencil in front of you. What is the area for any sector that represents 1/5 of the area of the circle defined by the equation x squared plus y squared equals 100? The area for any sector that represents 1/5 of the area of the circle. And Nick of Coe-Brown.
20.
They taking that, judges? All right, for the 10 points. Now what we want you to do is name the Pine Tree State, which joined the Union as a free state under the Missouri Compromise on March 3rd. Anthony of Coe-Brown.
California.
Manchester Central. Andrew.
Oregon.
You're going to hate yourself a little bit. The Pine Tree State is Maine. Here we go for 10 points. What weapon was used by Nantucket whalers? Ben of Central.
The harpoon.
Harpoon is right. We've got about 1.5 minutes to play in our game. What name referring to a vertebrate animal also describes a military operation that lands troops from seaborne vehicles? Ben of Central.
Amphibious.
Amphibious or amphibian, either one we would have taken. Of the 11 English kings named Edward, 2 had reigns which lasted less than 1 year. Name them. They were Ed Edward the fifth and Edward the eighth. Just under a minute to play. Here we go for 10 points. In 1994, Pulp Fiction won the Best Movie Award at the International Film Festival held annually in which city? Nico of Central.
Cannes, France.
In France. Cannes is correct for the 10 points. How many syllables are in a line of iambic pentameter? Justin of Coe-Brown.
10.
10 is correct. Now for 10 points. In which state was the Confederate States of America established on February 4th, 1861? David of Central.
South Carolina.
Coe-Brown. Nick.
Virginia.
It was in Alabama, in Montgomery. On which denomination of currency does the American Security Bank building in Washington appear along with the U.S. Treasury? Anthony?
$50 bill.
And it was the $10 bill. The sound ends, ending our game. Central got that lead in round number two and never looked back as they post a win tonight over Coe-Brown Northwood Academy to advance into our upcoming semifinal round. So congratulations to the Little Green and to the Coe-Brown Academy as well for their previous two victories. Now we go for one more quarterfinal round game, and that comes up 1 week from tonight. The participants will be Londonderry High School against Oyster River High School. That's our game 1 week from tonight. Thanks for watching, everybody. See you in a week. Good night.